What's up, guys? Back at the microwave zone. This man's gonna be microwaving Peep Justin for the 141st episode. So let's see what happens when he sticks it in a microwave.
So last year, I paid nothing for electricity, and I actually made money by using a sticker. Welcome to yet another episode of Microwave. Today I've got a real special surprise for all of you. But ever since I did Peeps for Halloween, you've been requesting that I show you how to do Peep Jaster. I've had a few requests over the past few months, especially ever since I did that really messy Easter special. Now I'm going to actually show you how this is done. This could be either my most viewed video ever, or it can get lost in the single peep jousting videos already on the internet. Anyway, what you need are marshmallow peeps, preferably the chip kind, like this, the little marshmallow chips, and toothpicks, and you should probably do it on a paper plate so you don't have to clean up one of your good dishes. And the way you go about them is pretty simple. You just buy them at the store. I'll show you how I do it. As you can see, I bought my peeps at the grocery store, but you can get yours at a candy store, department store, any place that sells them. Watch as I carefully remove the peeps of my choice from the rack and expertly balance them while carrying other things at the same time. I chose orange and blue peeps, but you can choose any two colors or color. You don't have to do exactly as I do, it's just a suggestion. And with the toothpicks, you're better off just getting regular old toothpicks. I was temporarily contemplating getting these plastic swords, but I realized I killed my smelling plastic in my microwave, so I just stuck with the traditional toothpicks. Now, to be honest, I was a bit surprised by these requests because a guy that blows up silly string and spray paint in a microwave is usually not the kind of guy you ask to show you how to do things with marshmallow peeps. But since I love my fans, I'll show you anyway. And what you ideally want to do is use peeps that are of two different colors, preferably contrasting colors. I picked orange and blue. This is not required, but it's probably a good idea to give you an idea whose peep you're going to cheer for. In this case, we have the orange chick. We have the blue chip. You can see right there. And what you're going to want to do is place toothpicks in them like they're holding a sword. You saw I was thinking of buying those little plastic ones, but I decided plastic melting in my home microwave is not what I want. And it don't really matter when I'm blowing up Lysol in a microwave out in the woods, but it does matter when it's my home microwave. You can see that peep has a sword right there. Right on the line, the sword's a little. You can see the swords are fairly close together. You want them to overcross. And as with the popular sport of medieval jousting, what you want is your peak that you're cheering for to puncture the other peak. And it usually is played by two people. Each person cheers for one peak, and if your peak punctures the other one first, you win. Next, what you want to do is take your vacant peak, place it into the microwave like so. And anyone who knows microwave knows that I usually don't talk during microwaving sequences, but I'm not blowing up a can of cheese whiz today, so you're not really listening for anything. But I'll make an exception with this one. You crank down the microwave for about 1 minute, and let's see which peak wins. I do believe orange peak is the winner. And when you're doing this, you're going to want to watch very carefully, because sometimes it's extremely close to being a tie. In this case, the orange peak won because his sword punctured the blue peak before the blue peak could puncture the orange peak. Closer inspection, it actually looks like the orange peak wasn't even punctured. Orange peak definitely won that time. Now let's try it again. You can see these ones have much better sword placement. This is much more akin to how you're going to want your jousting peeps to look than what my first one did. Also, I forgot to point out that it's probably better that you do this on a turntable microwave, but it's not required your microwave to have a turntable, but it's certainly recommended that, as most microwaves these days are equipped with them, that should not be a problem. Now let's see which peak wins this time. Like the orange peak was trying to get an early win in again, but missed, and it looks like the blue peak wins this time. Let's see if I'm right. Blue peak won. So that's it for peak jousting, and if this is actually the only episode you've watched so far, and I do a good or bad idea type of verdict at the end, much like the show, is it a good idea to microwave this, or going back even further, the cartoon Animaniacs, this one I'm going to have to say is a really good idea. It's completely safe to do. A lot of fun. There's absolutely no risk of fire in your microwave. When you're not microwaving Mentos and Diet Coke together, you're microwaving two marshmallow chips with toothpicks in them. and end up seeing which one pierces the other foot. Great idea. Definitely try this season.
So, is it a good idea to microwave peep dusting? It's a great idea. Another great idea on a microwave show.